stand here and look at you?
For a bit.
Okay.
This marriage is a serious covenant made before God and before all of us as witnesses. In acknowledgement of its holy purpose and the power of the occasion, please bow your heads and let us pray. God of love, who gives us the longing for and capability of loving, we give you thanks for Catelyn and Ben, for their open hearts and willing spirits, and for the example of love they embody here in our presence. Be with them on this joyous occasion of showing their love and making their vows. And be with us, their witnesses, that way we all be changed by what is said and witnessed here. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Turn around?
Nope.
Okay.
Little girls are coming.
Oh, okay. Tom, I'm melting your heart.
Everyone, please stand. We are gathered here today to celebrate one of life's greatest moments, the joining of two hearts. In this ceremony today, we'll witness the joining of Catelyn Creech and Ben States in holy matrimony. Who gives this woman to be married today?
I do.
Please be seated. Today we've come together to witness the joining of these two lives. For them, out of the routine of ordinary life, the extraordinary has happened. They met each other, fell in love, and are finalizing it with their wedding today. Romance is fun, but true love is something far more, and is their desire to love each other for life, and that is what we are celebrating here today. A good marriage must be created. It's never being too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say I love you every day. And it's not just marrying the right person, it's being the right partner. At this time, I would like to share some words from Catelyn and Ben. I challenge both of them to tell me why they both loved each other. Catelyn was first. Her five things what she loves about Ben. He is the calm to my crazy. He has to reel in the crazy sometimes. He makes me feel at home when I am with him. Just his smile makes the world okay again. We can look at each other and just die laughing and know we are both thinking the same thing. He makes me feel like the most beautiful woman in the world, even when I feel my worst. And lastly, he is my best friend. Ben. His five things that he loves about Catelyn. What I love about Catelyn is the way we get along when we're together, how we laugh together, and the way she makes me feel. I love experiencing new things together and traveling to places we haven't been to yet. I love how we're a team and we build each other up. I love the way she laughs and the way she smiles. And lastly, I love how she brightens my life. Time. Repeat after me, Catelyn. I, Catelyn Creech, take you, Ben States, to be my husband.
I, Catelyn Creech, take you, Ben States, to be my husband.
My partner in life and my one true love.
My partner in life and my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
I love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
I love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the difficult and the easy.
Through the difficult and the easy.
Whatever may come, I will always be there.
Whatever may come, I will always be there.
As I've given you my hand to hold.
As I've given you my hand to hold.
So I give you my life to keep.
So I give you my life to keep.
Ben, repeat after me. I, Ben States, take you, Catelyn Creech, to be my wife.
I, Ben States, take you, Catelyn Creech, to be my wife.
My partner in life and my one true love.
My partner in life and my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
And love you today, tomorrow, and forever.
And love you for today, tomorrow, and always.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will trust you and honor you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
Through the best and the worst.
For the best and the worst.
Through the difficult and the easy.
Through the difficult and easy.
Whatever may come, I will always be there.
Whatever may come, I will always be there.
As I've given you my hand to hold.
As I've given you my hand to hold.
So I give you my life to keep.
So I give you my life to keep.
Catelyn and Ben, I would ask that you always treat yourself and each other with respect. And remind yourselves often what brought you together today. Give the highest priority to the tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that your marriage deserves. When frustration and difficulty assail your marriage, as they do to every relationship at one time or another, focus on what still seems right between you, not only the part that seems wrong. This way, when clouds of trouble hide the sun in your lives and you lose sight of it for a moment, you can remember that the sun is still there. And if each of you will take responsibility for the quality of your life together, it will be marked by abundance and happiness. Catelyn and Ben, today you join your separate lives together. The two separate bottles of glass symbolize your separate lives, separate families, and separate set of friends. They represent all that you are and all that you'll ever be as an individual. They also represent your lives before today. As these two containers of glass are going to be poured into the third container, the individual containers of glass will no longer exist, but will be joined together as one. Just as these pieces of glass can never be separated and poured again into the individual containers, so will your marriage be.
Don't panic.
Hmm?
Don't panic.
You're going fast. Well, here. Yeah, I see that.
Love is the foundation of a great marriage. It is best described in the 13th chapter of the first epistle to the Corinthians in the New Testament. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrong. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. Catelyn Creech, do you take Ben States to be your husband? If so, please answer, I do.
I do.
Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others and holding on to him forevermore?
I do.
Ben States, do you take Catelyn Creech to be your wife?
I do.
Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others and holding on to her forevermore?
I do.
The ring is a symbol of the unbroken circle of love. Love freely given has no beginning and no end. No giver and no receiver, for each is the giver and each is the receiver. May these rings always remind you of the vows you have taken. Catelyn, go ahead and take Ben's ring. Excellent. And on the left hand. And repeat after me. I, Catelyn Creech, take you, Ben States, to be my husband.
I, Catelyn Creech, take you, Ben States, to be my husband.
To have and to hold.
to have and to hold.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In joy and sorrow.
In joy and sorrow.
And I promise my love to you.
I promise my love to you.
And with this ring.
And with this ring.
I take you as my husband.
I take you as my husband.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
Repeat after me, sir. I, Ben States, take you, Catelyn Creech, to be my wife.
I, Ben States, take you, Catelyn Creech, to be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer and for poorer.
In joy and sorrow.
In joy and sorrow.
And I promise my love to you.
And I promise my love to you.
And with this ring.
And with this ring,
I take you as my wife.
I take you as my wife.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
To make your relationship work will take love. This is the core of your marriage and why you are here today. It will take trust to know that in your heart you truly want what is best for each other. It will take dedication to stay open to one another and to learn and grow together. It will take faith to go forward together without knowing exactly what the future brings. And it will take commitment to hold true to the journey you have both pledged here today. Ladies and gentlemen, let us bow our heads in prayer. Our Father, we come here today asking for your blessing upon these two lives and this home being established. We are thankful for the love we see here and even more from the love we feel from you. May we never take this love for granted. We pray that your love will be a shield for Catelyn and Ben. When joy comes, may they share it together. When sorrow threatens, may they bear it together. In gladness or in tears, in sunshine or in shadows, may they draw ever closer to each other and to you. Grant them patience, gentleness, forbearance, and understanding, and protect their home from those forces that would break it apart. We ask for health, long life, for the fulfillment of every good dream. May their love continue through life and finally be blended into eternal life. Give them such fulfillment and mutual affection that they may reach out in love and concern for others. And grant that all married persons who have witnessed these vows find their love strengthened and their loyalties confirmed. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. By the power vested in me by the state of Indiana, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Ben, you may kiss your bride.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Ben and Catelyn.